Welcome to the Alligator office. We are here for senior day, about to honor two of our departing superstars. First up, Adam Berry from Steinhatchee, Florida. Woo! 2008, covered Florida cross country, softball, volleyball, men's basketball.
Yeah.
And most recently, the awesome spring football. He has interned at the St. Pete Times and MLB.com and was a coro for the Florida Times Union. Give it up for Adam Berry.
Thank you.
Next up is our superstar from Miami, Florida, Anthony Chang-Rang. Came to the Alligator.
Yeah.
Beats have included golf, volleyball, baseball, football, and possibly the nicest columnist to ever exist at the Alligator. He's been a coro for the Orlando Sentinel and the Tampa Tribune, and he too has been will be an MLB.com intern. Give it up for Anthony Chang.
Greg Luca here in the Alligator Sports office to talk a little Florida basketball. Season may be over for the Gators, but the news keeps on coming. Started last Saturday when Erik Murphy and Cody Larson were arrested in St. Augustine on charges of third-degree felony burglary as they attempted to break into a car. They did manage to get into the car, but the owner said that they didn't notice anything missing, just that the glove compartment was open and the dashboard, there was people looking around. You could clearly tell they'd been inside. Also arrested was team manager Josh Adele, who was charged with principal to burglary. Larson and Murphy were released about 4 a.m. Sunday morning on $5,000 bond. Larson was previously arrested the summer before in South Dakota on drug charges when he shared hydrocodone pills with a teammate. It's unknown at this point whether the 120-day suspended jail sentence he received will come back to bite him a little bit, if he'll have to go up there and serve any extra time on top of what may or may not come of this charge. Billy Donovan said that both have been suspended from the team, but he's waiting until he gets all the facts to make any further judgments about their future with the Gators.
You know, I made a statement that both guys are suspended right now from our team. I really can't take any questions and cannot talk about it because obviously it's ongoing. All I can say is, I'm disappointed in those guys. They're disappointed in themselves. And we'll have to wait and see what happens going forward. But I know some of you may want to ask about that, and I just wanted you to know up front I really can't talk about it.
The Gators are also in the midst of a coaching shakeup, as Donovan's lost all three assistants from last season. Associate head coach Larry Shiat left at the end of March to become the head coach at Wyoming, while assistants Richard Pitino and Rob Lanier left to take positions at Louisville and Texas, respectively. Pitino's move was motivated by his family, as his dad Rick coaches at Louisville, and Richard's expecting his first son sometime in the near future, prompting Donovan to think that it would be nice if he was near his family and Richard to take the job. Also a factor in the move was that he has the potential to be the head coach in waiting at Louisville, taking over for his dad at the point at which he retires. Donovan also suggested that the same might be true for Lanier at Texas, where he had previously served as an assistant, and might be the head coach in waiting for the Longhorns.
I think sometimes in coaching, you never know about timing and how things are going to happen. And certainly about 10 days ago, I lost a really, really dear friend and a great coach in Larry Shiat, who did some terrific things here, taking over the Wyoming job. And then here over the weekend, it was just really interesting. Two situations came up, for both Richard Pitino and Rob Lanier. I think everybody knows my relationship with Coach Pitino, his father, and the way I feel about him. And I think with Richard, having a baby here any week, the opportunity for him to go back home and be with his family, I think was something that was, very, very important to him. And, he did a great job. And, I feel sad that his stay was only for 2 years, because I've known him since he's been 4 years old and our relationship has been close. And to get an opportunity to work with him like that, meant a lot to me. But I'm also excited for him that he's going to be reunited with his family and be reunited with his dad. Rob Lanier, kind of a similar situation. He and his wife have very strong ties in Austin, Texas. Kind of the same situation in Texas. Maybe he's done this before in football, but there's a strong possibility, again, not all the details, that he could possibly be a coach in waiting in Texas.
Two of those vacancies have already been filled, as John Pelfrey and Norm Roberts have been brought on as assistant coaches for the Gators. Pelfrey was formerly an assistant at Florida, and served as Arkansas's head coach since 2007 before being fired at the end of this last season. Roberts has a past at St. John's and had worked extensively under Coach Bill Self in four different schools. Donovan said that both of the assistants and himself would be immediately back on the recruiting trail, starting last Friday.
One of the things I felt like I needed was certainly familiarity, because I think any time you've got Larry Scheid 7 years with me, Rob Lanier 4 years with me, Richard too, and knowing Richard my whole life, brings some familiarity in someone back here that knows me, knows Florida, understands the SEC, understands the program is important, so John's going to do that. And then being from New York and being the same age as Norm Roberts and knowing him and just the programs he's been at, the places he's had to recruit to, I thought, the situations become difficult, and obviously, he had the opportunity to go back to St. John's, and it didn't work out, but Norm is a terrific recruiter, a very, very high character person, very, very well respected. I think he'll be great for our program, our team, our kids, and he'll be back, he'll be in here tomorrow to get to work. So we'll have two guys on board right away. The third assistant right now is something, I'm looking at some things right now. Have not made a decision on that yet. When I'd make a decision, I'm not sure, but I certainly felt very strongly about Norm and about John. And recruiting period starts on Friday, so those guys will be on the road recruiting here on Friday, and then we'll get right back at it.
Hi, this is Alligator Sports lacrosse writer John Boothe. In only their second year in existence, the Gators lacrosse team has won its first regular season conference championship with an 8-7 win over Vanderbilt on Sunday. The big story of the week, however, was the Gators' first win over number 2 Northwestern on Thursday with a 2-point win, 13-11, at home. The Wildcats previously haven't lost in 38 straight games in the American Lacrosse Conference. Also with the win, the Gators have locked up the number 1 seed in the ALC tournament in 3 weeks, which will be held in Nashville. The Gators are led by the nation's leading scorer, Kitty Cullen, with 67 goals, and also the stellar play recently from inside the goal by Mikey Mahar, who has had 7 saves on Sunday, 13 against the Wildcats, and 10 against Johns Hopkins.
Adam Barry, to talk a little Florida gymnastics here. Gators competed in the NCAA championships this weekend, although it ended a little bit sooner than they'd hoped to. Florida fell just short, wasn't able to reach the Super 6, falling Friday night, mostly due to some poor performances on the beam, which has been their weakest event all season long. The Gators ended the meet and fell in their first two performers. They racked up a 48.125 score. That's their lowest on any event this season. Their first two performers fell. There were some bright spots, though. Marissa King, sophomore, left Cleveland, Ohio as the national championship on vault. She posted a 9.8750. That gave the Gators their first national gymnastics champion since 1998, when Betsy Hamm and Susan Hines accomplished the feat for the Gators. Freshman Elena Johnson also reached 3 finals on Saturday and Sunday. Miranda Smith also managed to take home 2nd nationally in the floor exercise.
Adam Barry here in front of the Alligator office. That's it. That was the last episode of the first season of the Alligator Sports video show, if you will. We had a great time filming it. We certainly started with some overly ambitious plans at the start of the semester, so I've got to thank some people for helping make this happen. First of all, to Greg Luca, my assistant editor and basketball writer, for taking the flip cam on the road with him at every Florida basketball game, home and away this season. Especially to Matt Watts for helping produce this thing and make it look a lot better than it started. And obviously, lastly, we want to thank you, the viewers, for everything you've done watching the show and helping it take off. We appreciate it. So check back this summer. Jesse Simonton and Matt Watts will be taking over, and they should be providing some video shows for you while you're away.